most of the time, what stops people from talking together, from collaborating, not necessarily rudely, but honestly and openly, is just plain old fear. We get into this mindset because we're wired to avoid danger. I mean, that's our survival mechanism. We're meant to avoid, but it's not just danger, it is perceived danger. The primitive part of our brain, our amygdala, has us wired to stay away from anything that feels like it's new or different or could eat us. But today's world, it's not so much about predators as data, as information, but our brain has the same reaction. So we back off of anything that feels new. And I'll give you an example. If you've ever, you know, you drive your regular route to work every day, those of you who are not New Yorkers or the rest of us who are driving, and you can pretty much go through the lights and you know you stopped at the red lights, but you don't remember them, you just do your thing. Go a different way, completely new route, and you're watching every corner, right? That is your brain waking itself up to newness. And it's really sort of potential danger because it's unfamiliar. And I'll give you another fun stat on this idea of familiarity. And women, you may hear sometimes when they say, we smile too much. I think that's nonsense, all that kind of. I was told early in my career I was too nice for the business, entertainment. And I thought, that's really does, I don't like the sound of that. I was a big believer in you can catch more flies with honey than you can vinegar. So I would kind of polite people to death because they got nowhere to go once you've been so warm and friendly. Anyway, but for women who were told, you know, if you it's not good to smile, or men too, that you're over-smiling, it's too subservient, here's a little fun fact. When you smile at somebody when you're being introduced, the odds of them remembering your name go up exponentially. So if you're smiling when you say, hi, tell me your name. Hello, hi, I'm Libby. And if you give me a big smile, I'm going to remember your name. And the reason is, it's just our primitive brain, friend or foe, friend or foe. Are you part of the tribe or not part of the tribe? Yeah, see, oh, I like her, I'm going to remember your name because I know you're not out to get me. And that's how wired we are and how much our brain controls our actions. In fact, there was a study done at Emory College in Atlanta. Any Atlantans in the room? Yes, yo Atlanta. So Emory, big neuroscience school. They did a study on fear, and what they did is, they always take college students, which always makes me fear for my children, but they hooked them up to electrodes, and then to MRI, brain scan, and what they said was, they were gonna give their subjects a shock at some point, and they would tell them, you know, within a 30-second span, second 12, we're gonna zap you. And not a lethal, obviously, but definitely an uncomfortable, a painful shock. And first they found many of the subjects asked if they could have a bigger shock if they got it immediately. They didn't want to wait even 30 seconds because it's like, now, shock me now, get it over with. But what they also found when they gave the shock, or even before that, when they scanned the brains prior to the shock happening, that the fear and the pain centers of the brain were activated. So everybody's brain centers of fear and pain were lighting up prior to actually experiencing any pain. So it was the fear that was so much more present than the actual pain itself. That's what got people stressed. That's what got them afraid, was the idea of that pain, of that shock to come. And they also saw, and this is a really relevant part, is that the parts of the brain connected to risk-taking and creativity shut down when the pain and fear centers were activated. So what that means is, if you take a level of stress into the workplace and you're dealing with this sort of stress, and stress is part of the business, you just have to learn how to live through it. But if you are dealing with change in a way that is, you're always on guard, you've got that fight or flight, that adrenaline going, you're stressed, you're less able to access the creative, the risk-taking parts of your brain. So just when you need it most, you're less able to use that part of you. So you really, there's a physiological reason for needing to let go of some of that stress and learning how to cope with that.